All right, let's get back to beginner hats. Okay, what's a really good beginner hat for somebody? Maybe you already wear hats, but you're just looking for something really cool, laid back, and versatile. I've talked about the Stetson Saxon, which is in black, even navy is like one of my favorite hats. It could be really cool and laid back just to wear all the time, hanging out at the bar with like a black t-shirt on. Or it could also be the dressiest hat in the entire catalog. Now, we flip the brim down, wear it with an overcoat. It's, you know, the classic, understated black fedora. It's as classical as it gets. It might even be, you know, the biggest seller of, you see, the 90s, the 2000s, you know. It was a really huge hat with older guys, younger guys, everybody. The Saxon has got a stronger brim than, like, something wider and with a raw edge, like a temple or something. And there are other alternatives. There are things that look like the one I'm wearing with the raw edge and slightly higher crown, which are almost the like European counterpart. We call it the Ken. The Ken comes in, you know, also designery colors too, like taupe and, you know, burgundy. It's incredible. And at 30% off now, everything is a steal. It's like a third off. It's incredible. Like $120 light felt hat. We've talked about those too. Great hat. The Blues fedora is a 2-inch brim, a little shorter than this. It's a 2 on the nose, and it's rollable. It runs a little big, so if you're like a 7 3/8 or 59, you have to get a medium, you know, instead of a large. But they usually do good in rain and blizzards and stuff, where you don't want to take your $200 brand new raw edge wide brim hat out. Those do really well, and they look fantastic. It's just the perfect style. Lower crown, welted edge, you know, perfect 2-inch brim. It's like the Sinatra hat. They come in a bluish-gray color that's almost not available in any other hat that size. It's a gray, but it's their gray is a little bit more of a blue-gray, you know, not like a brownish gray or just plain gray. It's got a nice, almost like Sinatra blue or something. It's very nice with the navy suit, with gray, black, anything. I like the Blues, which is a great beginner's hat, good for anybody who just doesn't want to wear their expensive hat out in the bad weather. Also, if you're going out on a date or something, talked about this, you can roll it, stick it in your pocket. But you can't really do that with, you know, most of your other hats, so it's awkward. You don't want to be the guy who's looking for a seat to put your hat, you know? So right now, if they're $125, you're getting like almost a third off, 30% off. So it works out to be, you know, well under $100. You get the box, you could ask for extra feathers. Old hats are really easy to maintain. You just get packing tape, and you just pack down the light foam, the edges, everything. Actually, it's the same way you maintain your fur felts too. Just get some packing tape from your shipping department, make little rings, pat down the edges, the underneath, top of the brim, the crown, everywhere. You're gonna have to make a few of those. Get every speck of dust off. Especially if you're ever gonna spray it, you need to always do that first. What else? Oh, thanks, Wes. Your painting is incredible. I had to make a couple of modifications to make it a little bit more like radio friendly and stuff, but it is fantastic. And the less trim, thank you so much. This is going to go on one of my guitars, tremolo system, thank you. Thank you, Big Davis, for that. Also the giver of the strap, thank you. I have another one of these guys coming in silver, the same model, I just ordered it. So that'll be here in about 2 days. I'll present that very soon. Getting back to the hats. A newsboy cap, okay? A flat cap, an Irish cap, something really warm that you can pull down maybe over your ears is great. What are you gonna do when it gets really so cold that you can't wear a fedora? All you can wear is a sweatshirt hood or a parka hood or something. That's the answer. You get yourself a really nice cap. You know, like a good bulky Irish cap or something like that, or one of those Stetson llama hair ones or something nice, and you'd be surprised. Also, you could toss it in your pocket, So again, if you're going out with the boys, you're going out to a bar or a restaurant, you're going out on a date, you decide you don't want to wear that inside, you just fold the peak under into like a little half moon shape and you put it in your pocket or your coat pocket or your sleeve or something, and you're good. It's as small as a ski hat or something, you know, or like a, what do you call it, a scully? We called them ski hats when I was, you know, ski cap when I was young. So yeah, that's something essential. I think, you know, even if you're not a cap guy, you probably look good in the right cap. You know, not a big baggy newsboy, but like a medium one, or like a nice flat cap, one of the like, real thick ones, like the snap cap, or the Tully, which is a big wide, thick newsboy, or the Hannah stuff, the Gatsby, or the carry cap. Any of that stuff is super warm, or ear flap caps, the ones that have ear flaps are really nice. You could fold them in when you don't want it, but you're walking home and you get caught in a freezing cold, like walk looking for a taxi, and you know, after midnight and your ears are just freezing, you fold those flaps down and you're like good to go, you know, you're fine. So they may look goofy at times, but when it's that cold, you get the last laugh, and the people with the red ears, they're the ones who, you know, you could laugh back at them, you know. So, you know, ear flaps will always look like Charlie Brown or something when they're down, but you fold them inside and you hide them away. We even have a hat like that. A couple of them. I forgot what it's called. It's made by Alfonso d'Este. It has one word, it's the name of a guy or something, but they're really nice. It's a a crushable roll, but really thick one. It comes in black cashmere, it comes in plaids and tweeds and stuff too, green plaid, navy and red plaid, and they roll, and they have ear flaps inside that you could hide inside, and they're cashmere. They're awesome. It's like the Whippet or the Style Master, but it's got, you know, the really nice bow on the side with that big kind of, instead of just that little two cross piece between the bow, it's got like this big square in the middle, and like the wind cord, and you know, the crown is a little less sort of geometric, and you know, like the Stetson one is very geometric, but this one is more like graceful, sort of almost sculpted, you know, has a sort of a aesthetic beauty to it. The shape of the teardrop itself, the binding is a little skinnier. I think everything about it is very elegant. The quality of the felt is just lasts and lasts and lasts. The quality, you don't see loose threads ever. So it's just a real nice thing. You don't get bad hats from them, like ever. Good quality control. Hamilton is something we're not going to be reordering this year because we have to order really big batches of them, you know, like 9 styles and then colors and all of them, and then, you know, you have to get all the sizes in, huge orders, so. But what we do have now is 30% off the whole shop is, you know. Hey, if you do place an order, mention that Kev sent you, you know, that you're a Kev viewer. Let them know at work that I'm still kind of here, you know, fighting for them and stuff. But yo, you know, I bought this watching Kev's videos. Hopefully when the COVID thing lightens up, I'll get back to work and it'll be safer for me to go back. My new new guitar comes in about 2 days. I also ordered a set of green LED position markers. I might put it on that too. Your style, so beginner's hats, I'm going to say almost anything light felt is really good to start with. It's good because you can pack away too, put them in your pocket. They take some rain. They're very cheap now. You can start in like an $85 in a level. The Blues is a great hat for somebody with a big head. They run bigger than any hat I've ever seen. Only the black, the gray, the brown, and the blue though. So if you get those in a double X, it's like a full size 8 or bigger. For most hat companies, if they have an 8, it's not a true 8. It kind of stops at 7 3/4 and just stops getting bigger at that point. So what you need is flexible hats with no leather sweatbands that move, you know. So hats with a ribbon sweatband in a size 8 will be better. or a light felt hat in a double X that runs big, which is the blues. So we have about four or five other models in double X, but the blues in those four colors run huge. I'm going to say about a size 8 and 1/8 ever, which is, yeah, it's like as big. A Cobra does run big, though. I've seen a Cobra 8 and even some 8 and 1/8, so they run nice. But yeah, we got a really big size, and you never thought you'd ever find a hat to even fit. You get the blues and the double X. Just don't get the olive, don't get the camel. Stick to the black, the gray, the brown. I think the blues are cool too, yeah. Mm-hmm.